Hello again, everyone. My name is Mario Tiozzo, and I'm the Data Analysis and Visualization Librarian here at UMB Libraries. Today, we are going to take a look at how to analyze the data in this spreadsheet and visualize it with a dot plot chart. Here, we have the price or cost of 4 breakfast items at 5 fictional independent restaurants in Toronto, Ontario. This is a somewhat similar example to your assignment in that the data is categorical, which means it has distinct categories. So let's start with getting some statistical information from our data, which will allow us to better analyze and visualize it. Much like the previous lab, we will need the average and the standard error. So this will be a little bit of a recap for many of you. First, we want to calculate the cost averages. We do this by using the average function of Excel. So we'll start by putting in title here and pressing the equal sign to tell Excel that we want to start a function, typing in average, opening the parentheses, and including the data that we want to include. In this case, the coffee cost. We close the parentheses and press enter. We can then go to the bottom of the cell here, the bottom right corner, click, left click, and drag to get the corresponding averages for the other items. We can test this by looking at either the coordinates or the highlighted fields to see that they are indeed matching. Perfect. Now we want to find the standard deviation of these items. And again, we press equals STDEV sample, or dot S for sample, we can press tab to finish the naming of the function or the formula. Highlight this coffee cells, close the parentheses, go to the bottom, click and drag. Now we have the number of observations. So that's the count function, equal count. Again, highlight the coffee data, close the parentheses, 5, which makes sense, there are 5 restaurants. We would expect to be 5 throughout. Click and drag, and it is, in fact, 5 across the board. Perfect. Now recall that the standard error is the standard deviation divided by the number of observations, or the square root, rather, of the number of observations. So we do this by pressing the equals sign to tell Excel that we're doing a calculation. We refer to the standard deviation of the coffee price, which is in cell B9. And if we were to press enter at this point, it would just return the exact same value. But really what we want is the standard deviation over or divided by the square root of the observations. So we will divide it by the square root, which is the function SQRT of the number of observations of coffee, which is in cell B10. We then close the parentheses and press enter. Now we can click bottom here and drag to get the standard error for the other 3 items. Okay, we now have all the statistical information we need to construct our chart. We have the mean and we have the standard error, which means we can build our chart. And we'll use a line chart again this time, but with a twist, because this is not continuous data like last time, but rather categorical data. First, we select our independent variable, which is items here on line 1, as well as the dependent variables, which is the average costs, which is on line 8. And remember that we have to press the control button in order to get both lines. We then click on the insert tab right here, and we can click on the line chart icon in insert ribbon, which is located right here. We get a number of different options, but again, this time we will pick the lines with markers options. It's important to note that the categorical data is on the x-axis, or the bottom axis of the chart. Okay, back to the chart itself. We will now right-click on the line chart itself, and we will select Format Data Series. This will open up a side pane on the side, which provides a whole bunch of options. We will go to the fill section here, and we will select the no lines. This will leave us with only markers. And if we wanted to modify these markers, we could go back to the fill sections click on the markers, markers options, and then we could select the fill, the color that we wanted, the type of shape that we wanted, and the size that we wanted. I'll select square for this time, just to be a little bit different, and it'll keep the same size and color. Now let's try to clean it up a little bit and make it more meaningful. First, let's add elements that we want to include. So let's include the standard error lines. We've already calculated the standard error over here, so let's include it in the chart. To do so, remember, we click on the chart, we press the plus sign, we press the error bars, but those are not going to be quite what we want. So we're going to go on options, more options, and we can go here to error amount, press the custom, press specify value. We'll delete the contents of the positive error value, and we'll instead include the standard error that we've calculated. We'll do the same thing for the negative values. We'll press OK. Now we have the standard errors for each item. Okay, that's looking good. Now we'll add the axis titles. Sign, press axis titles, and now we'll include explanatory titles. So on this side, we'll write price in Canadian dollars, and on this side, put menu items. And on this side, there's no unit of measurement. Perfect. Now let's clean it up and remove any elements that may distract our audience. Just like last time, we'll remove the grid lines, select them and press delete. We'll also remove the chart border. We'll go to border, no line. You'll notice border has now disappeared, and we will remove the title. Once again, we'll add a figure caption to explain the who, what, why, and how. Post something here. Figure one, mean plus or minus standard error, price Canadian dollars of 4 breakfast items. Data were collected from independent restaurants N equals 5 in Toronto, Ontario. Again, the caption doesn't really match the footprint of the chart, so we'll try to right size that. We'll say about this size. We'll press the merge and center. Wrap text. And left adjust it. We'll also highlight figure one and bold it. Now we will try to match more or less the chart with the figure caption. There's one thing that's bugging me though, and this is not necessary, but notice that there's a lot of dead space after $1.50. There's a lot of white space, so I would like to make that disappear. So in order to do that, we can click on the axis items, right click on there, and press format axis. This will bring up this pane here. We can change the bounds to whatever we want. In this case, I'll just make the minimum 1, and you'll notice that it has changed to 1, and I'll leave the upper bound the same. That way we can see the data a little bit more clearly. All right, that looks good. Let's do the same thing as we did last time. Let's make the background white. Now we can use our snipping tool. And we can paste that in a Word document or PowerPoint presentation, and we're good to go. I hope this was helpful. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again in the next video. Bye for now.